said good day, sir!
Save Miracle. They have the TP out from Sexy Bampo. The damage, though, is still enough. Big Daddy No Tail managed to finish him off.
Hello and welcome to the Defense LAN Finals live here from our studios in Berlin. My name is Zoe and I have the utmost pleasure of being your host for the next 2 days when all the action is going to go down in this tournament. And of course, not alone here. No, I am joined by our casters and analysts on our desk. Let's just take it from that side. We have Capitalist, we have Ryu, TobiWan, as well as Blitz. And of course, we're also going to have Durka joining us. And on top of that, we every now and then will also bring in some of the players if they have time and can make time to give us some insight. Now, we had a quiet this season, right? I mean, it started in September. The teams went quite a long way. The whole format has been a little bit different this time around as compared to the other defenses. Toby, maybe walk us through how the teams got here and what the format was like.
Yeah, we tried to make it a little bit more easier for a lot of the top teams to play, as well as give opportunities for other teams to come up. We didn't have like our big qualifiers. We just had like the first group stage, which then would qualify into a second phase group stage, and that would then bring four teams to the LAN finals. So it was a lot of games over a lot of time, but also some good Dota.
Definitely. So, and of course, this tournament here will also have a little bit of a format going on, and Cap will explain that one to you.
Yeah, it's
going
to be a pretty classic double elimination. Just best of threes all the way through until we have our grand finals, which is going to be a best of five. So it should be pretty straightforward. I know teams are going to be enjoying the double elimination format for sure.
Definitely.
Always having two chances in a tournament. You know, that's EG's bread and butter. Too bad they're not here, but still, you know, that's how they got it. That's old Na'Vi, too, if you want to say. They always come from the loser bracket back in the day, so.
I'm pretty sure a lot of teams will appreciate that format. I mean, in general, I kind of like the single elimination thing, too, because, you know, like, it's just like, this is your chance kind of thing. But of course, to have the opportunity to fight your way back up from the bottom is also always very nice.
That's the OG train, man. That's the majors. Really, that's what they did.
You don't want to go to a LAN and just one game and you're going home already, and you go to the hotel for the next, what, 2-3 days? Yeah. That's not fun at all.
It really is. Nope, but we, of course, will be seeing all those teams up until tomorrow. Let's quickly take a look at the schedule we have for you today. We're going to show you OG versus Team Alternate, and then afterwards Team Liquid going up against Team Alliance. And then we will be showing you the upper bracket final. Tomorrow we're going to have the whole run through the lower bracket up into the grand final. All of the games will be played in a best of three, apart from the final, which will be a best of five. Now, you already saw the teams right there on your screens, so I want to talk a little bit about the teams we will be seeing here. Maybe starting with, I would say, like, the favorite of the tournament. I'm pretty sure everyone would pick them as the favorite. Blitz, OG, what can you tell us about them?
I mean, they just won the major in a pretty exciting fashion. They were able to claw their way through the lower bracket, made the best run maybe in lower bracket history for Dota Total. And they did it against teams like EG, Secret. It's not like they had an easy path there by any means. This is a relatively new roster as well. Like, these players... The only players that I think have played together on a team together were Big Daddy No-Tail and Fly at one point on Fnatic, and then Fly and Moon Meander for that complexity lineup. But for the most part, they've got new players like Miracle. Crit has some competitive experience in Europe. He was kind of well known, but this was definitely his big foray into Tier 1 Dota. And they made quite the splash, finishing first. Really good drafts overall. It feels like this team has the most diversity when it comes to just straight up countering certain heroes like the Anti-Mage, the Queen of Pain. Because they can pick heroes like Meepo for No-Tail, they can adjust by letting their two core players kind of just switch around roles. It just feels really fluid.
And now they just need to prove, you know, whether or not they have that kind of staying power, right? There's a lot of questions about the majors and whether or not it was just a lucky run that they just got on a hot streak at the right time. Well, then they went into DreamHack, won that, and now they're coming to their third straight LAN and trying to win it all. So
yeah, it's kind of like what we've seen from Secret recently. They slowed down after the majors. They haven't been performing up to par, but OG, like, they have been, and it looks like they still want to win. So that's what I like to see coming into this event.
Well, the first team they will be going up against is going to be Team Alternate. Now, I would just straight up say they're probably the underdogs here in this tournament, the old Polish team. All those players are good players. They have the experience. They have been playing a lot of little cups and stuff. But what can you guys tell us about Team Alternate?
Well, since I've probably casted the most of Team Alternate, I guess I could probably talk about them. They really remind me of the old team, Four Friends plus Krilly, in that they've been around for a really long time. It's been Exotic Deer, Ali Sash, and Sasu, who unfortunately left the team 2 months ago. They were like this three-core Polish group that was together for the last couple of years. This kind of current roster has been together since February, and they're pretty much looking to play this out until TI, right, and just see if they could be the next, you know, CDC, Vega Squadron, etc. So, you know, so those amateur teams go pro and actually making their way all the way through. And I think that we've seen in Dota that it's much more important to have synergy and friendship within your own team than to have like these big skill names like we did from the old Secret, right? That was supposed to be the biggest team out there that was supposed to win all TI, and we saw where they ended up, right? Whereas teams that had a lot more gel to them ended up doing much better in tournaments. So I actually feel pretty positive about Team Alternate. They do have a stand-in in Robert G because they lost Sasu 2 months ago, so they're still trying to figure that out. But I think as a whole, this is a team to look out for in the next few months.
It's also a fun team to come to an event like this when you're going up against big names like Liquid OG and Alliance, which you know a lot about, and Team Alternate, while they play in the smaller cups, you don't have that big information and the experience playing directly against them. So they can be the like fly under the radar in that kind of regard. The tournament doesn't really allow for it too much because it's only a four-team tournament, but still, like, they have a better chance.
This is kind of like stepping up to the big dogs, and this might be where they can actually get some good scrims or good information, like you're saying. You know, if you're scrimming, you're probably scrimming, you know, the Tier 2 teams instead of the Tier 1 teams, and this will be a good chance for them to show up. It kind of reminds me of hopefully they can be like the Vega of ESL. You know, we saw them at ESL New York. Vega showed up. They haven't really showed up recently, but maybe Team Alternate can be like them, you know, at least pull up a win here or two. I don't know if they can take two games, but I know for sure they can take one game at least off one of these teams.
Yeah, they have routinely pulled games off of bigger teams such as Team Empire and Team Liquid, so I think Team Alternate definitely shown that some of their unique style and just their synergy together, I think they offer really good teamwork. That's probably one of the best things about them. I think that they've proven that they can actually take down some of the top dogs. They just need a little bit more staying power and prove, I think, bigger diversity in their draft.
Yeah. So the next team we want to talk about is going to be Team Liquid. They unfortunately didn't make it to the majors. However, they're still considered one of the top teams in Europe. What would you guys say about those guys?
Oh, I think Rui's got a couple of thoughts on this one.
Yeah, Liquid, man. We were debating about this earlier, like who is the top teams in Europe right now? Because we all know Secret's still at the top. New patch is coming out. We don't know who's going to be at the top after that. Then we have OG, basically systematically the same, because Secret did take off, you know, three tournaments, and then OG basically won the major, so that is kind of the TI. They are basically number one, so them two are at the peak right now. And then third place, I would put Liquid, just because, you know, VP hasn't been showing us anything. They just replaced Illidan. We have Vega not performing too well. Empire's kind of here. Navi and Alliance, they're kind of, you know, still trying to get back to form as well. So we don't really have this third place team in Europe right now, and I think that's where Team Liquid, I think that's where they are. And if they can, you know, just maybe one up OG here, maybe they can, you know, kind of squeak up to number two.
They were definitely to have at least some kind of win, because they haven't been able to get into a LAN to prove themselves on LAN.
They keep on getting run into that OG every time, their most feared enemy.
Yep, things just go horribly, horribly wrong for them online.
Yeah, I think this is kind of a second chance for Team Liquid in many ways, in that they were kind of one of the favorites for the majors qualifiers, and then they ended up faltering and losing. You know, going from upper bracket to being the first team out was pretty insane for the playoffs. So I think that they can kind of look at this as a second chance to prove themselves, as you said, on LAN, and hopefully be able to, you know, take on OG and see what they can do.
Yeah, and last but not least, we of course also have Team Alliance going up here in the tournament. Now, they unfortunately will be also showing up with a stand-in. Kebab will be covering the place of Minots, who has now left the team.
Yep.
So Alliance, yeah, they're still struggling, it seems, as of late, but
They're trying to find their place in the world.
Yeah.
Alliance is, you think they're back and then they're gone, then they come back and then they're gone again. It's really difficult, especially for Alliance, like hardcore Alliance fans, which there's a hell of a lot of. for them to know if their team's going to really perform. But they've had some really good results of late. Maybe not the greatest results they're looking for at DreamHack. Yes, they removed My Nuts. Things weren't clicking for them, so they switched that out. And now they try and find a new place. Kebab coming in to step and fill the role. Makes sense as well. They maybe even met up with him at DreamHack when he was playing there for Monkey Freedom Fighters. And then now he lives here in Germany, so it just makes sense for him to be here as their stand-in.
I really liked watching My Nuts, though. I mean, every time you see him on Tuskar, he was just an absolute monster. So I just really miss watching him. But still, they can always come back. I want to see if Kebab, you know, if maybe if he does do well, maybe he might move to Sweden. I doubt that's the case. They'll probably still look for that inner, you know, circle. But a win here for them is just definitely going to help them out, at least morally. Everybody thinks they're going to finish third, fourth. I'm hoping that they can, you know, take that next step, at least get second, give us a good grand finals, something of that nature.
Alliance's biggest strength has always been their unity as a team, and that seems to be holding strong with the four core members. It's just right now trying to find their, you know, fifth that actually works with the team and has synergy, and it seems like they're kind of playing it out for the long haul, you know, searching for a TI roster, not necessarily a roster that can go to a major. So I think that Alliance definitely can be one of the best teams in Europe and potentially the world. I mean, they've shown that before at TI3, but they do have really good players and really unique strategies as well. Their player pool is, their hero pool is kind of difficult to deal with, I would say, but they just haven't clicked yet in this TI6 era.
So what are you guys thinking about the stand-in for this tournament? I mean, Kebab, he's been around for an eternity, like back in the days playing with Syndra in MYM and so forth. But he then took quite a long break from Dota, it seemed, and was kind of going under the radar. And now he's back again as a stand-in for various teams. How well do you guys feel he's actually fitting into that roster now?
I would say he'll be sufficient.
Okay.
About it. I don't know what.
Wasn't Toby? Didn't you say there was one game with him? It was against VP, right? Where the night before, I think, where they did win against them 2-1.
Yeah, yeah. They were
with
playing
Kebab
with him as a stand-in for the start of the I-League.
That's at least a little bit of good. You know, that's a good morale going into the tournament. They didn't get 2-0'd. I mean, they won. I mean, that has to be something at least.
Yeah, I mean, when he played on MTW. It was a pretty talented roster. Like, they did fairly well. They were somewhat successful. When it came to TI, I heard some stuff that, you know, they just weren't gelling from a chemistry perspective. But he's always been a pretty talented player. Like, everybody in Europe knows it. I think it was actually his decision to take a break. It wasn't like he was forced out or anything like that. So to see him back into the scene is pretty exciting. I think he is a capable player. He's a good support. He's pretty stable. I've played with him before in leagues. He's pretty talkative. I think that the language thing is probably the biggest thing that holds him back from being able to join that roster, like, full-time. I think no matter how they perform at this event, they're probably not going to keep him, just because Lota said in the past they would really prefer it if it was just, like, an all-Swedish kind of thing, yep, just for communication and personality reasons. And so I think just because of that, there's a good chance that, you know, he won't stay with the roster, but he knows that already. Like, he's just meant to be a stand-in. He's probably going to have, like, no pressure on him whatsoever.
Because, easy money?
Yeah, it's just, you know, show up, collect a paycheck. If you do really well, you're pretty motivated for that, but that's about it.
Yeah, I like your point there, because if he does win, that gives him opportunities on different teams.
Exactly.
And then that'll be the next major, you know, he can make a team or something, and that'll help his future.
It's a critical time for that, too, because the roster's locked very, very soon. So kind of at the end of this weekend, if you don't have your team confirmed, you're...
How many people are we going to see play through that open qualifiers and get eliminated this time?
I don't know, but, like, teams are being created out of everywhere. There's meat, there's vegetables, there's fruit. Like, there's a whole bunch of teams coming up.
Well, but we have the four we have, and now we already discussed them. We will, of course, further discuss all of those teams right before their matches and go a bit more in-depth on each individual player. Also, I think I just before said MYM instead of MTW,
yeah.
So excuse for that. But we're going to head into a quick break, and then we should be back with the first matchup of today. OG going up against Team Alternate. Don't go anywhere. We should be right back.
I said good day, sir!